provide a detailed description of the birth of AI in Italy, we ask Luigia Carlucci Ayala. She has been indeed one of the founders of AI research in Italy. Luigia was professor in computer science at University Sapienza of Rome, where she founded the AI research group. She distinguished both for scientific achievement and services to the AI community. In particular, I would like to mention that Luigia was one of the founders of the Italian Association for Artificial Intelligence in 1988, and she was the first president. She was also the first Italian AAAI Fellow in 1995. AAAI is today the most important international academic society for artificial intelligence. She was the first Italian ERAI Fellow in 1999. ERAI is the most important European academic society for artificial intelligence. When do you meet AI?
I got a laureate degree in mathematics in 1968 in Pisa with a thesis on the semantics of programming languages. My thesis advisor has been Alfonso Caracciolo di Forino, a pioneer in the study of programming languages. At that time, I became interested in proving properties of programs. In 1969, when Ugo Montanari came back from a long visit to the United States, I knew from him about AI and what was going on in the leading US universities, Stanford, Carnegie Mellon, and MIT. In particular, I was intrigued by the research done at SAIL, the Stanford Artificial Intelligence Laboratory, founded and directed by John McCarthy. In July 1970, I attended the summer school on AI in Dubrovnik, where I got to know McCarthy and other renowned AI researchers. In that period, I decided that I wanted to go to SAIL, which I did in 1973 on a NATO grant. I knew about SAIL from Ugo Montanari, but also from Marco Sommalvico, who also had visited there. Both of them were enthusiastic about it. Sommalvico was active at Politecnico di Milano. Montanari, after his graduation at Politecnico di Milano, had moved to Pisa, along with a group of newly graduated guys attracted by the possibility of doing research and starting a curriculum in computer science at the University of Pisa.
Which were your research interests at that time?
My background was in mathematics and in what we now call theoretical computer science. My interest was improving program correctness and machine checking these proofs. So my research field was automated theorem proving, automated reasoning. I didn't dare to say that my research was in AI, too ambitious. I was tackling a sub-problem. The full problem sounded too big to me. From reasoning about programs, I moved to reasoning about mathematics, and considered mathematics as a sub-problem with respect to the idea of building an intelligent artifact. If a machine cannot reason about simple mathematical problems, how can we consider it intelligent? Then my interest moved to systems to represent and reason about knowledge, not only mathematical knowledge. Only then I had the courage to qualify myself as a researcher in artificial intelligence. And I also understood that reasoning about mathematics is not sufficient for a machine to show intelligent behavior.
Can you depict the Italian situation in those years?
In the 60s, in Italy, nobody mentioned AI as their research area. Don't forget that Alan Turing spoke about machine intelligence, and this name was used in the United Kingdom till the 70s. But let's consider research connected with AI. The places in Italy that come to my mind are Naples, where Eduardo Caglianiello at the Institute of Physics had started a group that did outstanding research in cybernetics and neural networks. Genova, where Antonio Borsellino at the Institute of Physics had started a group in biophysics and cybernetics. And Pisa, where a lot of research had started around the construction of the first Italian computer named CEP. Certainly, research on topics related to AI was also carried on in Milan, by Silvio Ceccato, and in Rome by Vittorio Somenzi, both philosophers. Not to be forgotten, the Jesuit Roberto Busa, who from the late 40s, early 50s, in collaboration with IBM, started the creation of the Index to Mysticus. That's to say, the digitization of the Opera Omnia of St. Thomas, thus starting the computational linguistic and the strong tradition of natural language understanding in Italy.
Where and when did researchers start to speak of AI in Italy?
To the best of my knowledge, the first researchers that used the name artificial intelligence in Italy at the beginning of the 70s were Marco Somalbico at Politecnico di Milano and the group where I belonged at the Institute of Information Processing of Pisa. The Institute of Information Processing had a section of non-numeric information processing, a weird name indeed. We could call it symbolic processing. Its original research agenda was in pattern recognition and image processing. The section of non-numerical information processing included Ugo Montanari, Giorgio Levi, Alberto Martelli, Carlo Montangero, Franco Sirovic, Mario Aiello, and myself. All but me were electrical engineers that had graduated at Politecnico di Milano. When Montanari returned to Pisa from the US, where in 1969 he had attended the first IGCAI in Washington, D.C., we proposed a research program in artificial intelligence. In the following years, we all went to the United States as visiting scholars, thus establishing research relations that we maintained over the years.
Which were the main research topics of that time?
No surprise, the Italian researchers concentrated on theoretical problems. In addition to our inclination, the fact was that our laboratories were extremely poor in terms of hardware where AI software could be developed and run. Of course, I know better the research carried on in Pisa. From those years, it's worth mentioning the linear unification algorithm proposed by Martelli and Montanari, pioneering work on constraint programming by Montanari, and work on ANDOR graphs by Levi and Sirovic. In addition, a very innovative programming language named Magma Lisp, a dialect of Lisp, was developed by Montangero, Pacini, and Turini, and used for a long time for applications in computational linguistics at the Institute of Computational Linguistics of the National Research Council. Finally, let me mention PPC, Pisa Proof Checker, a theorem prover based on lambda calculus implemented in Lisp with a technique that later on became famous as object-oriented, developed by Mario Aiello, Giuseppe Attardi, Gianfranco Brini, and myself.
How did research in AI spread around Italy?
AI spread around Italy in the 80s. First, the group of researchers active in Pisa became full professors and moved to several Italian universities. And in each of them, they started a research group in AI. The Italian Ministry of University and Research launched a program of research projects of national interest. The idea was to focus the research of several groups around a common theme. At that time, Marco Somalbico and myself decided to apply with two distinct projects, robotics, coordinated by him, and AI, coordinated by me. Both of them were funded, even though with very little money. These projects constituted an incentive to coordinate our research and form a national community. In my project, I coordinated units in 12 universities in the first application, 17 in the second one. AI was attracting attention, and this was very positive. We held a yearly meeting, exchanged results, and got to know each other.
Two milestones in the 80s, Ichkai 1987 in Milan and the foundation of AIPRIA, the Italian Association for Artificial Intelligence.
Our national projects were hardly perceived in Italy. Conversely, we strengthened our good reputation in the international AI community. This certainly counted when the board of Ichkai, the most prestigious AI conference worldwide, chose Milan and Somalvico to organize its 87th edition. Marco did a great job in organizing a memorable event and prepared it with many initiatives to promote the conference and the attention on AI and robotics in our academia and industries. After the success of the national projects, and mainly of Ichkai 87, the time was ripe for the foundation of a national association, which we did in 1988. The Italian Association for Artificial Intelligence. And through it, we connected Italy to the other European association within ICAI, now called URAI. The Italian Association for Artificial Intelligence is still very active. It publishes an international journal and promotes research in Italy and abroad. With the newly created association, we felt ourselves also ripe for the proposal of a big progetto finalizzato from the National Research Council, a big national project to foster the cooperation of academic research and industries. We worked eagerly and put together a very good project for the time, but the time was not ripe for the National Research Council and the Italian academia. Our proposal was never rejected, but without any explanation, it was lost in some drawer and never approved. A real pity. Luckily enough, the European Union was launching the first round of ESPRI projects, and we got in Brussels the recognition we didn't receive in Italy and survived the winter.
What about teaching AI? When the first academic courses on AI started?
At the end of the 80s, our ministry was in the process of approving the institution of a curriculum in Ingegneria Informatica. Marco Somalvigo and I proposed, through our universities, to include a class in AI. This was approved, so Somalvigo in 1990 at Politecnico di Milano and I in 1991 at the School of Engineering at La Sapienza in Rome have started the first classes in artificial intelligence in Italy. The first year, my class was attended by 19 brave students. Then, quickly, it attracted more than 100 students.
AI and Italian industries during the 80s and the 90s.
The attention to AI has always been very high in Italian industries and in research laboratories of Italian companies. The industrial involvement has been instrumental in the foundation of the Italian Association for Artificial Intelligence, even though it has not been uniformly high over the years. It may be considered odd nowadays, but at that time, while a number of startups were blooming abroad, in particular in the USA, in Italy, academic startups were considered very badly, a betrayal of the purity of the mission of academic research. The times of the entrepreneurial university had yet to come.
A comparison between AI in the old days and nowadays.
Today, it's really a period of high tide for AI. The results obtained in the solution of real-life, socially relevant, complex problems have attracted a lot of attention and created many expectations. The results are due to the advancement of research in AI, the development of specific models and methods, and the impressive advancement of the digital and communication technologies. Different from the past, when researchers in AI were considered more or less a minority of weird and eccentric nerds, now everybody claims to do research in AI, to use AI, or to apply AI. In a word, AI is very fashionable, even too fashionable and overexposed, maybe. This may be dangerous if the fashion is not accompanied by an increased knowledge and by investments in research, development, and experimentation in the usage and acceptance of artificial intelligence systems in our work and living environments.
Thank you, Luigia, for having shared with us your memories and experiences and your valuable contribution to the AI community.